Good afternoon, everybody, and thanks for joining us here on the web. We begin in Whitefield, where crews continue to clear a deadly truck accident this afternoon. State police say a truck driver was killed when his truck loaded with steel beams went through an intersection, hit a gas pump, and ended up on the side of the Johns River. Ray Brewer has the story.
It was around 6 o'clock Tuesday morning when this tractor trailer ended up over the riverbank, killing the driver. State police say the driver was heading north on Route 116 in Whitefield and failed to make the turn at the intersection with Route 3.
And he come down over the hill, and there was a glare of ice, or over the glare of ice, and he couldn't stop.
Dave Skinner was out salting the area in front of the store where he works and saw it happen.
He went through the intersection, hit the pumps, and down over the bank, and hit a couple of cars going down over.
I just heard, like, squealing tires, and I didn't think anything of it. And all of a sudden, I just heard this really loud noise, like a big boom, and metal, like, crashing.
Sam Golden says she could also see a little fire, and so she called 911. Before plunging over the riverbank, the truck sheared off one of the gas pumps. Fortunately, the safety valves on the tanks kept the gas from leaking.
Fire departments assess the situation and don't feel as though there is an environmental impact. There was minimal spillage of fluid.
The truck was carrying a load of steel beams, some of which ended up crushing the cab. While the accident remains under investigation, state police say at this point it's impossible to say what killed the driver.
There was a load shift. At this point, the cause of death has been undetermined.
As of noontime Tuesday, police had not released the identity of that driver. Officials say at the time of the accident, the state was actively treating those roads. Well, an early morning fire destroyed a processing plant at an organic egg farm in Monroe. When firefighters arrived at Pete and Jerry's Organic Eggs on Bufflam Road around 1:30, there was heavy fire coming from a building that was under construction. Crews from several towns in both New Hampshire and Vermont were called to help put out those flames and protect the rest of the farm.
The new construction was already, you know, pretty much a total loss. So at that point, we went right into defensive to protect exposures on the existing operation and, you know, make sure that there weren't further damage.
No one was hurt and there were no chickens or eggs in that building. The state fire marshal's office is still working to figure out what caused the fire. Two men faced charges after police say a man was robbed and stabbed early this morning in Manchester. Two alert officers happened to see the alleged suspects fleeing the scene on Walnut Street and were able to quickly make an arrest. Police say the men are accused of demanding money and drugs from the 18-year-old victim, and one pulled out a knife and stabbed that victim several times. 32-year-old Anthony Lopez is charged with robbery and second-degree assault. 34-year-old Rafael Diaz is charged with robbery and criminal liability to second-degree assault. Maine game wardens are searching dumpsters as part of the search for a missing toddler in the town of Waterville. Wardens could be seen outside a fitness and nightclub this morning and also at a Comfort Inn as the search for 20-month-old Ayla Reynolds enters a fourth day. Dumpsters are about 4 miles from where she was last seen, sleeping at home on Friday night. About 75 law enforcement officers are taking part in the search for Ayla, and investigators say a neighbor helping in that search did find a sippy cup yesterday. Well, starting tonight at 5, the Gift of Life, bystanders and 911 dispatchers jump into action, working together to save a local man who collapsed on the job while now recovering. We're there as he meets with some of the people who helped save him. That's at 5. That does it for us. Have a great afternoon, everybody.